Welcome YouTube to the 19th annual Fostoria Rail Festival. This event, happening every September 25th except for in 2020, is an event that I always mark in my calendar. I got a late start after going to the train show and spending over $200 on stuff that I didn't need, but the day still worked out better anyways. Right on time as usual, here comes NS Train 21T. Hammering across the diamonds, doing 40 miles an hour. A little while later, here comes a CSX train coming out of North Baltimore. I believe this train was Q157, but I didn't hear the train ID. Thank you. A little while later, here comes undoubtedly the hottest train of the entire day. By hot, I do not mean looks, I mean hot as in the priority scale. This, and the railfan industry, is what we like to call get you fired trains. This train carries UPS cargo from the West Coast and is bound for New York City. It has been told that if you delay these trains, it'll end your career on the railroad. After Q010 clears up, here comes the southbound Q150. Q150 comes out of Detroit and heads to North Baltimore. He takes the turn here at Fostoria. Thank you.
Always good to see you.
I swear, this shirt becomes gray after this. It's already gray.
The train of the day, at least for me anyways, was the CSX train T515, a coal train bound for the Toledo docks. Seeing a train run straight through on the CNO is not a very common sight. Adding to the rarity is that this happened twice this day. I believe I saw the returning train U515 the week earlier. Undoubtedly, the most unusual train of the entire day comes along the old nickel plate after L71 enters the yard. This Norfolk Southern train was symboled I-18. This indicates that it was an extra section of NS train 218. 218 normally handles steel cars all the way to Fostoria where they drop them off. However, Norfolk Southern this day decided to run an entire extra train. Me and a few other railfans here were quite confused of why Norfolk Southern needed to run an extra train, especially an extra section of 218. But we weren't going to complain much as it's Norfolk Southern and we're in the era of PSR. Today was a very slow day, especially for Fostoria on a Saturday. The next train on the list is CSX train Q215, coming around the corner to head north towards Toledo, and I presume Detroit.
Thank you.
left tower in the foreground, CSX decides to run another train on the Willard sub. This, I believe, was CSX train Q369, but I once again did not get the train ID. With all the foam, rail fans in the foreground, CSX decides to run another train, as they always do. This is train Q560. He comes out of Cincinnati on the Toledo sub, where he takes a right turn at Deschler to come through Fostoria, and then eventually up to Selkirk. For a few months, CSX rerouted this train over the Indy line, I presume due to low priority. However, it has since again been rerouted over its original routing. It kinda sucks because the Indy line deserves more traffic than what is run on it. Thank you. The slow day parade continues. A little while after Q560 passes, here comes CSX train Q368. Hours have passed, and the evening light is starting to come in. Finally, CSX decides to run another train around the connection. This time, it is Q200. decided to stay over at this part of the Iron Triangle for the rest of the day, as I didn't expect much. CSX had barely any crews on duty at North Baltimore or Willard, so everything was backed up. One of those backed up trains happens to be this mixed freight, Q370. Backed-up parade continues, as CSX sends one of their other hotshot intermodals over the diamonds. This was CSX train Q016, not as hot as Q010, but still an expedited train. CSX finally had crews on duty this evening, but unfortunately, it came too late. Here comes one of the backed up trains, CSX train Q158. At least I think it was. By the time CSX started running anything else, it was already too late. CSX had four or five trains that were stacked up on the Willard sub, but this would be the only one that I could get due to my dad's willingness to have to get home to his precious golden retriever. This is mostly why I like to go places by myself these days. This is CSX train Q137. You can tell by the single stack intermodal cars. After this train had passed, I was forced to leave. But the Fostoria train show gave me a few rare items to add to my collection. If I could live any place in the world, this would be it. But that's just a dream. As an added bonus to this movie, here is my catch of CSXT 3194 leading Q331 to Avon, Indiana today. This catch fully completes my need to hunt all three of the CSX Pride and Service units. With Q331's passage, we close out this program by saying thank you, CSX, for giving me the opportunity to film all three of their special interest units in 1 year. For now, this is Buckeye Nation Railroader, signing off from Central Ohio.